Student/teachers, did a student get expelled decided to take revenge on the school afterwards? Essentially, we had a miniature cult on our hands at our high school. Let me explain. I'm a retired high school principal from a different time, a time where teachers were free to enact their own version of physical punishment. I'm not advocating for it. In fact, I think it's pretty much responsible for why this story exists. The kids learned violence from us. Anyways, we expelled a senior in his final few months of school because he was constantly getting into scraps with the other students. At least a few a week for several months. Every time we pulled him into his counselor's office, we got the same answer from him: they were provoking me. So, we eventually had to expel him. What we didn't anticipate was how many people would take after his example. The day after he was expelled, there was another fight, seemingly provoked by a student who'd never been in a fight before. When we asked him about his behavior, he responded with "bring expelled kid's name back." It was freaky, but what was worse was that it continued for the oncoming weeks, with fights happening almost every day, sometimes multiple in a single day. Each kid had the same eerie response, some kind of idealistic image of this guy who'd been expelled. I'd never seen anything like it. After 3 weeks of this, I was ready to take some serious actions to get to the bottom of this, but it turned out that I didn't have to. The expelled kid showed up on school property with a few of his friends, who started egging these kids to fight each other under threat of being attacked themselves. I called the police pretty much immediately, and a few of the teachers ran out there, yelling at them. They ended up scrambling off, but the fights themselves continued. The kid was eventually arrested at his own house, and was tried with assault. He was 18 at the time. After that, the fights slowed down significantly, but there was still the occasional incident where his name would come up again. Just the creepiest thing I'd experienced in all of my years of teaching. So when I was in middle school, there was this kid that decided to smoke weed in the bathroom stall on my hall, stupidly. The entire school, which was small, reeked in a matter of minutes. As soon as some of our more uppity teachers caught a whiff, they took us all out into the hallway, where they searched through our bags, and, strangest of all, started smelling our hands. They ended up singling out this wiry blonde-haired guy, and dragging him to the front office, where we didn't see him for a long ass time. There was a lot of commotion up at the front of the school that day. Apparently his father was some kind of school board official, and he was trying to get the whole thing pushed under the rug, but it simply was not going that way. I remember as a 6th grader being positively frightened at the yelling that was erupting from the front offices, the booming voice of the father echoing through the school. It ended with him, red in the face, shoving the front door aside as he dragged his son by the ear to his car, where they went home. Presumably he was expelled. A few months later, we have an end of year school dance, which the entire school is basically required to attend. They had the front doors wide open, and I guess at some point the weed kid must have snuck in. About halfway through the party rock anthem, we started to notice a rank smell from the hallways. It wasn't weed, but instead like 20 stink bombs scattered around. As soon as I got out in the hallway, he zipped by me, throwing down one last one before running out the front doors, blonde hair bobbing. I think I was one of only a few people to actually see the kid in action, and he never got caught. What a legend. Dude lol, alright. Imat set the stage well for this one. I was in 7th grade, in Spanish class. Usually we had this teacher named Mrs. Diz, but one day we had this substitute teacher who was a short black lady. This was the what are the odds class. We had a group of like 6, and we'd play it literally every single class. Mrs. Diz usually didn't give too much of a shit, but we noticed that it was getting on the substitute teacher's nerves. I challenged one of my buddies to a 1-20, with the dare that he'd go up to her and tell her that her hair looked like his pubes. He agreed, and we both said 13 at the same time. Dude was shitting bricks, and I told him he could back out if he wanted to, but he didn't. As soon as the bell rang, he went right up to her and said it. You could sense the incoming storm. Her face grew super red, and she grabbed a nearby folder and threw it at my friend. My friend isn't really one to take a lot of shit, so without skipping a beat, he threw it back, smacking the teacher in the face. Security materialized there within like an instant, and ended up taking him away. He, crazily enough, had enough prior offenses to get expelled for this, and got transferred to another school. We stayed in touch though, and not even a week after he got transferred, the same substitute teacher came to his new school, and was in one of his classes. According to him, the substitute teacher saw him, and immediately refused to sit in the class with him, which earned him school-wide infamy, in a good way. They didn't fight like last time, but he said he told her that her hair looked like pubes one last time as she left the classroom. I was rolling with laughter. Kind of a long one. I had a student that was suffering from chronic depression, and showed up less and less as he went through high school. By his senior year, we'd see him once a month, if that. It culminated enough that eventually he was approaching the limit of school days that a student can miss and still graduate. We'd bring him in with his mother to talk about it and make a plan, and then that plan would go down the drain within a few days. So, people stopped caring. He was expelled due to absences. From what we were told, he went and got his high school diploma from an adult schooling program and then took out a loan to go for a teaching degree. He ended up friending me on Facebook, and to say the recovery he made was incredible would be an understatement. Kid ended up graduating with honors and getting hired to the same school he'd previously been expelled from. Ironically, I was still working there at the time. Another few years passed, and I finally built up the nerve to ask him what had changed, what had caused him to suddenly care about his future. He said something along the lines of having an abusive household, and that getting away from them built him back up. The teaching degree was to ensure that no kid fell by the wayside the same way he had. That year, I decided to retire from teaching, and it was also the year that his career really took off. He ended up getting several awards that year for outstanding merit and dedication, and proceeded to win the same awards for the next 2 years, before being promoted to an administrative position. Here he was arguably even more successful, transforming the very attitude of the school. The piece of information that really tops the ironic cake, however, is that as a part of the administrative staff, he was responsible with ridding the district of the absence rule. Now, kids could not get expelled for going over a certain number of days. It was senior prank time, and some of us were a little ballsier than others. Namely, a red-headed dude named Derek, who decided that it would be a brilliant idea to, well, actually let me keep the suspense and describe the day instead. It was a crisp autumn day, and we'd just got done filling our school with an inconceivable amount of Batman symbols. They were everywhere. Doors, windows, desks, ceiling tiles, school banners, I mean, you name it, it was signaling Batman. A team of like 20 students, including me, had worked all night on it, and it was finally done. But, as you might expect, this wasn't the only senior prank going on. Our aforementioned buddy Derek had also come up with a little solo plan. Ours was sprung perfectly. Much to the displeasure of all of the staff, the Cape Crusaders mark filled their hallways. There were classes to be done, so most of the disposable staff had to start cleaning it up. Pretty good, not as good as the time we planted a tree in the middle of our football field, but still pretty good nonetheless. At the end of the day, in Homer Room, that's when Derek struck. You see, there was always a little school news program thing we had to watch, made by the students themselves. We tuned in when Derek, who was part of the news team, and another girl came onto the screen. Things went pretty normal until there was an announcement for the astronomy club, who were having a big get-together to view some kind of comet or something. Well, and I'll never fucking forget this, Derek began to speak, and said, "And for a special sneak preview, for those who've never gone to the event before, here's a view of the full moon." Before anyone could intervene, he climbed onto the desk, and mooned the camera, revealing his ass to the entire school. Pandemonium erupted. Someone grabbed him off the desk as the girl sitting next to him made a horrified face, before the feed was cut off. Our classroom plunged into chaos, and I assume the entire rest of the school did too. It took forever to get control of everyone again. I remember hearing that he was expelled, and that he'd also been charged with sexual assault. But, this story is about revenge, and I'm not even close to done. Derek was none too happy about being expelled, and things were about to get far worse. Things had pretty much settled down by the time he had returned, and oh, he returned alright. Nobody knows how he got in, but in the same vein, that we'd left the Batman symbol everywhere in the school. One day we arrived to see a screenshot of his ass plastered all over the school, in droves. This was a concentrated effort of multiple people, just like ours had been. And Derek, that sly dog, he never got caught for that one, but I'm sure he was responsible. There was no way to link him to it. It could just been any student trying to get a rise out of the staff. Unfortunately, we were on really thin ice after that incident. We had to expel this one child for selling drugs at the bus pickup area after school hours. He was brave enough to do it while the buses were still around one day, and I'm sure he thought he didn't appear suspicious, but he stuck out like a sore thumb. This was in South Carolina, where drugs are an especially bad no-no, so he was tased and arrested almost immediately. Kind of brutal, but whatever. The kid was transferred elsewhere, where he became someone else's drug dealer, no doubt. But he left a present behind for some of the front office staff on his way out. It went unnoticed for several weeks before a strange smell started to permeate through the office. It was found in the attendant counselor's office, in one of desk drawers under a hefty stack of papers. A small plastic bag filled with marijuana, not completely sealed, so over time, the smell began to leak. At first, they suspected the attendant counselor. It wasn't the first time that a teacher had decided to come to our school high. So, naturally, we checked the security cameras. It took hours to find, but we found it. A short chubby boy wearing all black, sneaking into the counselor's office. He'd escaped from his entourage in the front office, with just enough time to slip a baggie in her desk. It was super slick, far more competent than what he tried at the bus loop. Of course, the suspicion was dropped against the attendant counselor, and the police confiscated the drug, probably for their own private use. I never saw that kid again. Hope he's still out there doing stupid shit like that though. I was a junior in high school when a fight broke out in one of my English classes. I have no idea what it was over, and there's a good chance I wouldn't care even if I knew. Girl on girl. So obviously there was a lot of hype. Our teacher, some feeble lady that forced us to call her drive or suffer the consequences of disrespecting your elders, was helpless in the face of 30 students chanting on a fight. There was the usual hair pulling, slightly obscene clothing grabs, and a lot of name calling, but the real problem began when one of the girls took off her flip-flops and began smacking the other girl in the head with it. At this, the girl who was being hit screamed, "Alright, bitch, you ain't ever about to wear those again," and proceeded to bite the other girl's left big toe clean off and spit it out onto the tile floor. Then, the screaming commenced. The teacher, who up until that moment had just been cowering in a corner, was actively calling the police. A school security guard separated the two, and the excitement, unfortunately, was over. The girl who bit off the toe got expelled, while the other girl just got hit with a bunch of disciplinary stuff. She wasn't gone forever though. Now, I heard this secondhand, so you'll have to just take my word for it, but I don't really think it's beyond reason. Apparently the girl cornered the minus one toe girl after school one day, demanding the big toe on her other foot too. She was a fucking psycho. They fought again, and this time the girl with the missing toe won. By some miracle, she ended up only losing a single toe. That day and the infamous toe biting psycho was never seen again.